Hello and welcome to our method tutorial series on creating a basic app. So far in our app, we have a screen to add and edit a car, and now we shall remove it forever. We shall add a delete button to our new edit car screen. Customize this screen, and into the bottom section, drag a new button control to the left of the save button. I'll select it and change its text to delete. Scroll down and change the background color to secondary. Now, on to its actions. Click the down arrow on the delete button and go into its click event. The first thing we'll do is show a message. If you've ever deleted anything on a computer, you know it will prompt you with, Are you really sure? Find and add the show message action. We'll change the title to say, delete confirmation. And the message will be, are you sure you wish to delete this car? And then here, we're going to change the buttons. We'll select OK Cancel from the drop-down. The OK Cancel button is a special feature within the Show Message action. If a user selects Cancel, all the actions below Show Message will be ignored. Hitting Cancel basically stops the action set where it is, and we don't need to use a conditional statement. You may remember conditional statements from a few videos ago. At least, I really hope you do. Anyway, I'll put in an internal note. Great, now for the deleting part. Add another action, search for delete records from table, and select it. Note the name of this action. It's delete records from table. It's plural. If you set up this incorrectly, you could possibly delete all the records in your table. So make sure you don't do that. How do we make it just delete one record? Remember in the last video, we passed the record ID to our edit screen? In fact, the record ID is stored in memory. The record ID is a unique identifier. I know I keep saying this, but it's important. With the record ID, you can pinpoint the record you want in a table. Here is a list of my cars. I added a few more. Let's say I want to delete Lemon Car. It has a record ID of 5. We will get the computer to search through the records in the car table, looking only at the record ID field until they find the record which has a record ID of 5. And when they find this record with record ID of 5, they will delete the record. Let's go back to our delete records from table action. The first thing we need to select is a table to delete from. In the drop-down, choose the cars table. Next is this thing called the criteria builder. Open it up. You will notice it looks a lot like setting up a conditional statement. Let's add a condition. The way this works is the delete action will delete every record which matches this statement or condition. Yes, you can delete more than one record with just one statement. Let's delete one though. The condition we'll make is where the record ID field of the table equals the record ID we have stored in memory. The first dropdown has all the fields in our car table, so we will find the record ID field. Is equal is the default operation, so we'll keep that. And the third value is the exact value we wish to match to within the table's record ID field. When I open up this dropdown, I see a number of places where we can get this value. And you may be wondering, hey, where does the computer store the record ID of the car we're editing? And if you're asking that, huzzah, good for you. The record ID is known as the active record ID and is stored within the session. What's a session? A session is the period of time you spend logged into method. And during that time, the computer remembers all sorts of things about you. In this dropdown, there are a few things you could choose under session, but we want the screen active record ID. Great, let's click the back button and do a recap. We want to delete a record in the cars table. The computer will search through the table's record ID field, looking for a record that matches the active record ID stored in the session. To translate our specific example, we want to find the record which has a record ID of 5 and delete it from the cars table. Phew, let's put in an internal note. Delete record with the screen's active record ID. One last thing, add a new action and find Go to Screen and select it. Navigate to Back Browser History. For after navigation, choose Close this screen. If you're wondering why we don't use Call another action set, the back link on this screen does not close the screen. We want to make sure this is done. Internal note, browser back and close. Great, let's review our action set. First, it pops up a message asking if the user is sure. If the user cancels, all these actions will be ignored. But if the user selects OK, it continues to the next action. This action will identify the car by the screen's active record ID and delete it. And then the GoTo browser screen will go back and close the new Edit Car screen. Awesome, let's close this so we can test it out. Go into our Cars app from the left menu, and let me choose the lemon car. As you know, behind the scenes, its record ID is stored in the session screen active record ID. When I hit delete, it brings up this confirmation. I'll hit cancel. Ta-da! Nothing happens. No delete. It's safe. Let me hit delete again, and this time I'll say OK. And look, it brings me back to the list screen and the lemon car is gone. It worked. There is one small problem. If I add a new car, the delete button is there. How can I delete a car that doesn't even exist? You can't. In the next video, we will make this invisible when adding a new car. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.